Hello and welcome back to thematic session one. Hopefully you've joined the right sessions. And this session is going to be about creating open data ecosystems. Now, our first speaker is Bastian van Leeuwen. And Bastian is the scientific coordinator of the Horizon 2020 program, director of the Knowledge Center Open Data and associate professor at the Faculty of Architecture and the Built Environment of Delft University of Technology. His speech is entitled Towards Sustainable Open Data Ecosystems. So I'm all ready to listen to you. I've got my cup of tea here. Hopefully more of you have your warm drinks and you've had a chance to network as well. Bastian, over to you.
Thank you very much. Yes, thank you very much for having me and my talk on sustainable open data ecosystems. See how it works. Yes, it works. Yes, towards sustainable open data ecosystems is indeed the title of an Horizon 2020 Marie Curie European Training Network program that's running from October this year until October 2025. And I'm coordinating this program. The aim of this talk is to introduce a new educational program to advance current open data systems towards being open data ecosystems. The educational program is designed for 15 PhD students that will be employed through the program and will research the sustainability of open data ecosystems. See how it works, yes. The central question to this project is how to arrive at a sustainable open data ecosystem. We think that above all, it is in building capacity. In this program, we're going to train the trainers and to train the next generation open data ambassadors. Before I continue, I would like to give a definition of open data, which we define in our project as data without any restrictions in the reuse and provided free of charge. And it's clear to this group of people that our societies will benefit significantly from the extra value created by using open data. However, we will not benefit if the open data ecosystem is not sustainable. And that means it's not healthy or in good shape and the interests of all stakeholders are satisfied. Current educational programs do touch upon open data, its benefits, maybe some strategies to implement it, and hopefully some critical reflection on the current status of open data in the world. But as far as we know, there is not yet a program that provides a holistic view on open data, the open data ecosystem perspective. The educational program that we designed was designed by an integrated team of eight academic institutes, 17 non-academic partners, which all have and are highly involved in open data research and open data practice. We're covering many aspects, including governance and technical aspects. And we're also covering multiple domains, journalism, geoinformation, agriculture, law, computer science, and primary schools. And together, we're going to address five challenges. The first challenge that we see is that there is a current lack of skilled people to use open data. Research indicates that many businesses and governments do not have the knowledge and skills to decide on and implement effective strategies of how to make the best use of their data. There are currently not enough people who have the right data skills. In other words, the availability of data is not a sufficient condition for open data to actually become a resource for innovation. Whoever is able to gain access to open data should also have the appropriate skills and competences to use it. Of course, not all of us have to be open data expert users, but improved data skills and competences for all would be something that we all should strive at. That brings me to the second challenge, that the current open data ecosystems lag behind in value creation. As a consequence of challenge one, at the global level, the EU, at least the EU, is significantly lagging behind in terms of innovation information businesses. And the value created by these EU information businesses is lagging behind. Not only Europe has markedly fewer information businesses, on average, they're also significantly smaller than their counterparts in the US and Asia. The third challenge that we are addressing in our project is that existing open data ecosystems are not user-driven. Although the role of users is assumed to be critical for the success of open data ecosystems, current systems are driven by suppliers. This means that provisioning data from governments to end users is often made through a one-way data portal, without differentiating between various types of users or providing data in a way that the supplier, not the user, perceives as satisfying. The fourth challenge that we see is that existing open data ecosystems are linear. Users of open government data typically capture value without adding value back to the system. At the moment, only few stakeholders in the ecosystem profit from open data, and usually the ones who profit are not the ones who invested most effort, time, and money. As a result of, you could say, unfair distribution of value in the open data ecosystem, some stakeholders are reluctant to participate, or those that are participating are reconsidering their current role. The fifth challenge, and the last challenge that we are going to address in this project, is that current open data ecosystems are exclusive. Research and practice are mainly focused on a very limited selection of open data provider and user groups, namely governments as data providers and companies as open data users, while many more roles and stakeholders exist. As a consequence, open data systems only include open government data and barely any non-government data, and communication is limited between a few parties. That is why the interaction with industry, civil society, and government is essential to ensure that open data initiatives are inclusive. That means addressing the needs of society at large. All should have access to and benefit from open data. It should not be limited to the happy few. So if we summarize the current situation in most, if not all, open data systems in the world, you could say that they are supply and driven, exclusive, linear, and based on best effort. That's creating some value, but certainly not living up to this potential. So if we are moving towards a user-driven, inclusive, circular, and skills-based ecosystem, there will be much more value created, and as a consequence, the ecosystem will be much more sustainable. The 15 PhDs in this program will together design strategies to develop our current open data systems to true open data ecosystems. So the challenges that I just mentioned, if you take a look at the first two, these are addressed in the training program that we designed, and the last three challenges of how to arrive at a sustainable open data ecosystem is addressed in 15 research projects that we identified. Here's a list of these 15 projects. Together they will result in a strategy for arriving at a user-driven, circular, and inclusive open data ecosystem. Topics vary from governance-oriented projects, such as project number one, which will design strategies to build data capacity in citizens, to more technical-oriented topics, such as topic number seven, focusing on the interdomain semantic interoperability. Projects 9 till 15 are dedicated to understand the needs of specific user groups, such as journalists in project 9 or elementary school students in project 10. What do these user groups need, and how can we involve them better in the open data ecosystem? But ADECO is not only about research, it's primarily about training the 15 PhDs to become the next generation open data leaders. They will be trained through our training program. Our training program consists of four different training instruments, which you provide the candidates with knowledge and skills to apply holistic, interdisciplinary, and intersectoral thinking and practices on open data ecosystems. We start with the first training instrument, individual PhD training. The PhD candidates will be part of a PhD program and enroll in a local doctoral school, but they will enjoy, and we think this is special considering PhD supervision, they will be supervised by two academic tutors, one from the local university and one from an international partner university, as well as a tutor from practice. Typical, the organization where the PhD is going to do his or her research secondment. Then the second instrument that we have is an online training program. The first aim of this program is to create a common vocabulary within the consortium and introducing the PhDs to the concept of the open data ecosystem. The online training program will introduce the concept of open data ecosystems in the first module and then focus, lots of clicks, on specific technical and non-technical aspects of the ecosystem in the later modules. After 8 modules, the PhD candidate will have a pretty good understanding of open data ecosystem theory. This is then followed up by 5 training weeks. In these training weeks, the knowledge will be deepened in dedicated weeks where we focus on a specific topic, and the topics are also related to the challenges I just mentioned. You'll see here on the slide a training week towards your user-driven open data ecosystem, focus on circularity, focus week on inclusiveness, and in the end, it will be on finding a strategy, the proper strategy towards implementing a sustainable open data ecosystem. Fourth instrument that we're having, or the third instrument, is the network-wide training weeks. And in these training weeks, well, all have the same structure. And I will take the first training week as an example. You see that the first day, the PhD students will present their work to the entire consortium, which most likely will get a lot of feedback from the many perspectives, because the entire consortium will be there, 25 organizations. Then we have 2 days of masterclasses, one on sharing practical experiences in open data, and then the second masterclass day will be a more theoretical focus. And in this particular instance, so for the first training week, they will be educated in the interdisciplinary learning, for example. The fourth day is on professional skills training, learning about intellectual property rights, ethics, group dynamics, and on how to organize a public event. And in the final day, they will launch the public event. Then the fourth instrument we have is the communication and public engagement activities. They will, of course, be involved in the outreach event in each training week. In addition to that, they will write blog entries to stimulate interest in the general public. Then each of the PhD candidates will organize a public engagement event as part of their secondment. And they will do this, organize this event together with the professional non-academic partner. Of course, it's in academic, so they They have to present the scientific conferences and publish in peer-reviewed journals. And of course, at the end, they're going to organize and participate in the final conference that we are going to organize. Then finally, towards the end of the project, we will deliver a MOOC on open data ecosystem. And in the MOOC, we will integrate the new insights coming from the PhD research that we performed in our research. And the online training program and the MOOC will be input for design and development of the open data curriculum on open data ecosystems. Now the presentation is gone. What happened?
I'm not quite sure what's happened. I'm sure they're trying their best to get it back. But meanwhile, I can throw in a little question for you from the audience. And the quest. Oh, no, I think it's back. I'll allow you to continue. Okay.
Well, this is almost a fine slide because the final slide was. Yeah. I need to have control again. Yeah, okay. Yes. Then the final slide here. We just started this month, so in October 21 we started. This project is running for 4 years. We are very eager to cooperate with as many partners as possible. So if you would like to participate in our RECO program, please let us know through email, website, or follow us through social media channels, and I'm sure we will get back to you as soon as possible, because we would like to have as many people included in our project as possible. And that was the end of the presentation.
Thank you so much, Bastian. And I think you've done a wonderful job there advertising what you need and what you supply in the terms of PhD candidacy and other things like that. Now, I've got a question here from Mohit Kapoor. He says, I am an urban planner and researcher on open data platforms for sustainable urban planning in Germany. How can I get involved with ODECO or contribute to ODECO over the next year?
Well, very simple. Drop an email, the email address that just was on the slide, or just go to ODECO /research.eu, and we'll be in touch. It's simple as that.
That's a very simple answer indeed. Second question from Annika Zuder-Wilk in Delft, actually, Technology University. You refer to open data ecosystem theory. What do you mean by this exactly?
Well, it's interesting. Annika is one of the participants or one of the supervisors in this project. Yeah, this open data ecosystem, that's an interesting concept, and we have to develop it throughout the project. But at this moment, we see in the world of open data that it's very much on pushing open data towards the portals and then leave it there. And with the open data ecosystem, we also include this interaction between different stakeholders. So that should be aware that they are mutually interdependent in the creation and delivery of the value from the data. That also means that they have a joint responsibility. So the one cannot do without the other. And only unitedly they can make or break the system. And that's what you are with an ecosystem. Together, you're going to build it and make it sustainable.
And final question for you. There are more questions coming in, but I suggest that people write to you directly because I'm trying to keep to time and we've got three parallel thematic sessions on the go. This is from an anonymous person who very much liked your presentation. Thank you for the information, they say. This anonymous person has two questions, so if you could answer briefly, please, Bastian. What types of public value do you think can be created in an open data ecosystem? And secondly, how could this creation be measured? Thank you very much, they say.
We have one PhD project that's really going to focus on how to create this public value and how to assess it also. So that's an excellent link to this PhD project that's going to be supervised by the University of Leuven. Public Governance Institute is on there. Yeah, what types of public value can I mention? We have this general theory, of course, with transparency, anti-corruption, better involvement of citizen in public decision making, and all these aspects are typical for open data. So you could expect the increased value there of this open data ecosystem, because if you understand the needs of the citizens, they will be probably more involved and better take advantage of the data that is available there.
Thank you so much, Bastian. Thank you ever so much for your time. It was very interesting. Loved your energy. And I'm quite sure you're going to have the PhD candidates emailing you very, very soon in that diverse range of topics. Thank you.
Thank you very much.